everyone, this is Nick, and today I wanted to show you a video that I posted before, but from a different chart type. So we have long looked at visitor experience ratings, satisfaction ratings, other experience ratings in places like visitor serving organizations like museums, zoos, aquariums. This might be a pretty common chart that you might see, a really standard bar chart. Nothing is so wrong with this bar chart showing visitor experience ratings. Maybe these are like the top two box of like a Likert type scale rating on a survey or something like that. But there could be a kind of a more fun, engaging way to present this chart. And I wanted to show you this chart over here. We made this in a column chart format before in Excel. And I wanted to show you how to make this chart in PowerPoint. So this is kind of a fun bar chart. It has those rounded corners at the end, kind of gives you this impression of like racing to the finish line a little bit. Not sure that's necessarily what we want, but it's a little bit more visually appealing or engaging, something that might catch your reader's eye and just let people kind of rest on these data just a little bit. We also have a really nice title at the top that we sort of color coded with welcoming and fun, and that corresponds with the two blue bars in the chart. And then we have the gray bars at the bottom that kind of de-emphasizes those data if you want to do that. So what I'm going to do is escape out of this slide, and I'm going to show you how to make that chart right from this bar chart. So this is a bar chart that we just put a standard 2D in PowerPoint. It's the standard 2D clustered bar chart that you just put in. It's the horizontal bar chart. What we need to do is transfer this over to a stacked bar chart, and I'm going to show you how to do that when you embed the chart right inside PowerPoint. So we've embedded charts in PowerPoint all the time on my channel. You can check out some of the other videos on how to sort of do that and then how to edit data once the chart is in the PowerPoint slide. But you're going to have this beautiful bar chart right here in PowerPoint. What we're going to do first is we are going to right click, and then we're going to say edit data. And this is going to pop up with our data source menu right here, or a data source kind of Excel sheet. Remember, Excel kind of lives behind the scenes in PowerPoint when you embed a chart inside a PowerPoint slide. And these are, this is my data series here. Right here, I'm just going to label these, label that data, and then these are my survey items, or the labels on the y-axis of the bar chart. Now I'm going to have to create two more series of data. The first series that I'm going to choose, I'm going to put right over here in column D. This is going to be called, I'm just going to call this spacer, it doesn't matter what you call it, and I'm just going to say 10% down the entire row here, okay? So 10% in each of those are going to be the same values, and then what we're going to do is, I'm just going to call this transformed data, and what we need to do is create a little formula here. So what I'm going to do is say equals, I'm going to say this cell right here, B2, that's my data, and then I'm going to subtract the 10% from D2 right here, and I'm going to push enter, and that's going to give me that all the way down. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this over so that all three of my series of data are in this chart. Now, if you look over here behind the scenes, you can see my Excel chart is updating in real time, and it's this sort of clustered format. We definitely don't want that. So what we're going to do is close out of my data source. With the chart highlighted, you'll go up to the chart design tab on the ribbon. And what we're going to do is change this chart from a 2D clustered bar chart to a stacked bar chart. Not 100% stacked, just a regular stacked bar chart. So we're going to go over here to change chart type. And then I'm going to go, we're right here on the bar chart menu already, go right up here to this middle one that's called stacked bar. And I'm going to click on that, and we're going to go ahead and say OK. Now, it looks a little bit funny. We have to do one more thing. I'm going to go ahead and select the data up here, and the select data source menu is going to pop up, and you see that we still have those three series of data in our chart. We actually only want the transform data and the spacer data. We don't want this data. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to uncheck this box. We won't remove it completely for some reason if you ever wanted that. Actually, we do need that for the labeling trick at the end. So you're going to keep the data. You're not going to remove it. You're just going to uncheck it from the chart. And I'm going to click OK. And now you see that the chart kind of transforms a little bit. So actually, this plus this bar plus this bar equals that 90%. So they both total to the actual data in the source. Okay, so I'm going to close out of this, and now we can make some design tweaks, okay? So I'm going to go ahead, and I'm just going to color all of these bars with kind of a standard gray color. I like this one right here. And now what we need to do is we need to embed an image into this top cluster, right, or this top stack, this top series right here. So to make it around, we're gonna go up to the Insert tab and insert a shape. And then what I'm gonna do is go down here to the flowchart menu. I like this sort of, kind of half circle-ish, or kind of like a bullet shape right here. I'm just gonna go ahead and insert that. It doesn't matter what size you have it. We're just gonna insert this like this. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna recolor this to be the gray color that I like. And I'm gonna make sure to select no line. That's really important. So what we're gonna do now is I'm just going to right click, copy this so that we put that on the clipboard on the back end. And now I'm going to click on this blue series of data right here. And I'm just gonna do right click and paste. Oh, it looks like I actually can't right click and paste. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna highlight the series and then I'm gonna push Control V. That's the keyboard shortcut to paste. So we're gonna paste it in and it pastes that image right inside that stack. Now look at that, you have this beautiful bar chart right here. Now we need the labels on the bar chart because remember on this version, we have the labels right here, but if we were to right click and add labels, it's actually just gonna give us the 10% because that's the actual value of those data. So in order to get the actual value of the survey rating here, we're going to go ahead with the labels selected here, go over to the format data label menu, and instead of value, we're gonna uncheck value and we're gonna click value from cells. When we do that, the data source menu opens and now I can point to my actual data range right here. So I'm just gonna highlight that, click okay. And that looks really good. Now you can see we have this bar chart with the kind of stylized rounded corners at the end, and then our actual data lives here. Now we want to highlight, we want to go back to this chart, we want to highlight these two in blue because that's what I wanted to highlight in my title. So I'm gonna go ahead and just recolor this to the blue, oops, and then recolor fun to the blue. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click twice on the bar that I want to highlight, and we're gonna isolate that one single bar and update the fill color to blue. I'm gonna do the same thing with this one. And now you see we need to have these two rounded shapes. We need to have those blue. So I'm gonna go up to my rounded shape right here, right, that I have. I'm gonna go ahead and fill that with the blue color. Really pretty. There's no line. Make sure there's no line on it. And there already is because we formatted it correctly to begin with. I'm gonna say Control C to copy. And then I'm gonna isolate this data point right here and push Control V to paste. And then the same thing with this one, Control V to paste. Now we have this beautiful kind of stylized bar chart with rounded corners at the end. I don't need my spacer bullet anymore. If you wanted to keep it off to the side, you could, or you could just delete it. And if you wanted to update maybe the gap width of the bars, highlight the bars. Right now it's set to 50%, but maybe I want to bring it all the way down to 30%, make it nice and big and chunky. That's really nice. And you could, of course, just kind of play with the height and the width of the chart if you wanted to. But that's kind of a really cool way to sort of just stylize your bar chart and create a different kind of look and feel for a standard traditional bar chart. Now, this technique I saw first from Layla Guarani on her Excel Plus channel on YouTube. I'm going to link below to her channel. It's a wonderful channel. Please subscribe to that. She is a wealth of knowledge, especially in Excel. You can learn a lot from her channel and from her online courses. And in her first video that she did this with a column chart, and we kind of updated our chart with the extra colors and kind of drawing our reader's attention to those specific data points. A pretty cool way to do. So I hope you try this technique in your work, and if you do, go ahead and let me know how it goes in the comments and how your audience or your reader liked it. If you liked this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and of course the bell next to it. Every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word, you will get notified every time that new video drops. I had a wonderful time making this for you. I hope you had a good time watching it, and I can't wait to see you all next time.